2018年は大臣女子フライ級に注目の女たちが集う。
柔道界から来ました、渡辺香菜です。
マッチョすぎる柔らちゃん渡辺香菜。
インターハイで2位になったり、高校2年生の時にアジア大会で全日本視点の強化選手に入れていただいてたので。
柔道で多くの輝かしい成績を上げたバッキバキのマルキー女子。所属していた名門実業団を退団し、今年かねてからの夢 MMA へ転向。デビュー戦ではアマチュア日本王者をパウンドで攻め立て、得意の腕十字を決める。
その本トップで柔道やってきた選手が MMA にちゃんとアジャストしてやっていく姿、皆さん見たくないですか？
新生現る先駆者、ついに来たる。
杉山静香30歳です。
強すぎる静香ちゃん、杉山静香。
ジュエルス旗揚げの時にデビューさせていただいて、
体育の先生をやりながらリングに上がり、空手仕込みの打撃だけでなく寝技も得意とする。彼女はいわば女子格冬の時代のヒロイン。戦いと女性としての幸せ、その間で彼女たちは揺れる。格闘技を諦めたくはなかった。
まあ、こんなにも女子の試合が組まれるのはやっぱレイナちゃんとかみんなの活躍があってのことなので、私がその流れにもっと勢いつけたいです。
追い焦がれた大舞台、待ちに待った私の出番。
腕十字で一本勝ちします。
まあ一本勝ちはないですね。
負けるつもりはないですね。
総合格闘家として正々堂々戦いましょう。
ニュースターか、パイオニアか、宝石たちが夢舞台で輝く。杉山静香 VS 渡辺香菜。
There she is, Kana Watanabe. It'll be her second pro mixed martial arts fight. She stands 5'6", came in at 126 pounds. That one win was against Hikaru Sato at Deep Jewels 18 in February of this year. A very excitable fighter. She has all the makings. I know she's got that judo background, but she has all the makings of being a star here in Japan.
Super nice. Super sweet, very easy to interview. Part of that new group of champions that wants to have respect to bring martial arts back into mixed martial arts. She's very respectful, obviously with a huge judo background, and judo being so popular and so tough here in Japan. She literally will be a star by the time she's 5-0, if she gets to 5-0. Now, you have to question a person that comes from a strong martial arts background, what happens when they lose? How do you react? We've all seen fighters that come and touted very, very good. They're super, supposed to be super exceptional. They come and they start fighting. They get on a run. They're getting all this popularity. And then they take a loss. And all of a sudden, you can't get a hold of them. You can't get them to answer you back. They don't respond to Twitter anymore. They kind of go dark. And it's the way you treat your losses that are the most important. Of course, she's only 1-0. It's very early in her career. She's hoping tonight at the end of this she'll be 2-0. We have to wait and see, but legitimately, Joe, I agree with you. She will be a huge star if she handles the overall pressure of being in MMA. Being an amateur sports in judo, the pressure is not as much as it is in mixed martial arts.
Japan. Shizuka Sugiyama. Hachire, hachire,
hachire. Ladies and gentlemen, I know we're taking a look at Shizuka Sugiyama, but unfortunately the cameras are not on Frank Trigg and I. Frank Trigg is literally dancing to this song. I don't know what to do. I'm trying to keep things as professional as possible, but Trigg right now is grooving to the tunes that Sugiyama has decided to come out to. Listen, she's been around 15-4-1, Frank, obviously taking on somebody who's 1-0. You know that she should be the favorite. She should be the heavy favorite. Coming into this fight, she's a minus 265 favorite. Watanabe is a plus 185. You look at her, you think she should win, but this is mixed martial arts. Sort of like doing commentary when your broadcast partner dances. You just never know what's going to happen.
Yeah, I want to go ahead and thank the entire Canadian population for allowing Joe Ferraro to film me with the bus again in a live broadcast. So I like to dance to Japanese music. Is that a fault? I mean, so when you look at Sugiyama, she obviously has a lot more experience. She's obviously, but what the question becomes is, it's a husband and wife team that fights professionally. Yes. Obviously, her husband fights in the UFC, and I believe, personally, that having two fighters in the same house doesn't get you have your most high potential. Because there's so many things that have to go on, different times of training camp, different diets at different times of the year. There's different things that go on, but these two somehow seem to always be in sync. So I'm wondering if this can make her a better person overall.
I mean, there is not much difference between the two. Yes, there's a height advantage for Watanabe. It's not much. It's 1 inch. She's obviously 1 year younger, but it's the experience factor for Sugiyama that could be the difference here.
Again,
they're going through the rules here, Frank. Herzog doesn't get a break. He's fighting right away, or he's reffing immediately.
Yeah, so 12 fights tonight. I think there's 3 refs. Each guy will get 4. Jason's doing the first 2, and he'll probably get a couple more later on.
All right, here we go. Clappers of ladies mixed martial arts here at the Saitama Super Arena. Kana Watanabe taking on Shizuka Sugiyama. Far more experienced is Sugiyama, as we mentioned. This one is 3 rounds, 5 minutes. The ladies, unlike our first bout, they're actually beating each other out here. Examining the distance. Who's going to make that big strike first? It's all about feints, Frank, as you know. What is your reaction when you throw a jab? What is the reaction if you try to throw a combination? Where does the fighter go with her footwork?
Well, obviously, we're going to make the assumption that Watanabe wants to go ahead and step inside and try to make this a judo match. Throw
Absolutely.
To the ground. Her throws are extremely violent when she gets it landed in there. She will throw you and readjust you. So you do land on your head, neck, and shoulders. As a result, she has a better shot of getting a knockout through a throw or catching a submission. She obviously won by armbar, a big throw to an armbar in her first fight. But obviously, Sugiyama knows that. She watched the foot. Oh, nice right hand coming across
right there. Exactly.
She knows that's going to happen. So she's obviously spent a lot of time in her training camp trying to make that stop from happening. So we're going to see a lot of short arms. She won't throw a bunch of punching combinations, hoping that she doesn't get caught up. I see her throwing a lot of 1-2s, throwing maybe 3 punches at a time, but nothing more than that, because she doesn't want to give Sugiyama a chance to step in, or Watanabe this chance to step in and catch her.
Trying to pay attention to Watanabe's footwork here, and especially her left hand, because you know she would love to get that underhook. and then send, you know, Sugiyama flying in the air. Oh, look at that trip.
Wow, nice foot sweep.
Beautiful.
Now this is a different fight. They're not separated. Now if there's contact, it becomes a question of, is Watanabe's judo style, is her ability to hold and close the gap without a gi on going to translate now into mixed martial arts? I want to know. We're not sure if that can happen or not. We have to wait and see what's going to happen, but she's definitely looking for her Koichi's, Orochi's, and Uchimata's very, very early. And there goes the short arm. See, and then Sugiyama got the short arm to make sure she doesn't get caught and get thrown down on that overhand wizard. And catch her with the right hand coming right through.
There's the kick to the body. She threw a nice left to the liver early in the fight here. But as you can see here now, Watanabe trying to get the leg up. Again, she's going to try and get that distance. Oh, she answers back with a right hook.
Wow, good foot position by both fighters. Good positioning.
Hands are a little lower than normal. Now that could be an effect for Watanabe. Oh. Right there, and strike the trip again.
Kind of does something very strange. She throws an overhand right, and it looks like, oh, she's a judo girl. It looks like she's trying to do a foot sweep at the same time as throwing that right hand. But what she's actually doing is kicking it in the ankle. She's not trying to do any kind of sweep. She catches the sweep, which we saw earlier, and falls down. Then she's okay with it, but she's really not looking for a foot sweep. She's looking to kick her in the back of the calf is what she's trying to do, which is very interesting.
It's almost like they're both respecting. It's not a lot of power that's landing, Frank, but they're respecting the fact that if they get too close, there's going to be some leather foot. She's trying in there to inner strip there. She gets it.
Wow.
Has to get on top there. Now she's going to get the hooks in there. She's got a minute and a half here. The arm is going under the neck, Frank.
Her Neiwaza game, her ground game in judo is exceptional. She is incredible at this position, but like I said earlier, there's no gi. Let's see what happens without the handles of the cloth. One to slow things down, but also give you some place to grab onto to make sure she can't escape.
As you can see here, the right forearm is sliding slowly in the neck, but she's got it. And she, you know, Sugiyama's got to be careful when she does play the hand game. Oh, she did a good job
there.
But again, she saved herself there. A great job there by Sugiyama, preventing the rear naked choke. Less than a minute to go here. Watanabe had her where she wanted her.
Oh, now she's trying to throw her to the ground. Like, in this position, if I'm in this, I'm trying to get away at this point. I'm not trying to hold on. But she's trying to step and take her back. She's trying to throw her to the ground and put herself in the best position to win this fight on the ground. It tells you one of two things. She doesn't believe that judo's any that good, or she has so much confidence in her own ground game, she wants to get on top and prove that she's got the better submission.
I'll go with B on that one there, because she has been taken down the ground, because if you've ever tried to get... Anytime you get close to a judoka player, someone I've known for a very long time up in Canada, Justin Bruckman, if he so much as touches you, you're going to go flying.
I watched Justin work out a couple times when I was in Toronto, and I could not believe the speed that once you get close to him, he literally has you on your head before you even had a chance to set your feet.
There we go, opening round in the books here between these two ladies. If you're going to give it to, if you had to judge this round here, Frank, would you give it to Watanabe with those takedowns and the submission attempt, or Sugiyama with some of her striking? I personally would give it to Watanabe.
You're going to have to give it to Watanabe because she's had the most significant amount. Both of them hit each other. Both of them kicked each other. There was a partial takedown in defense and got back up, and then a full takedown with back control before she gets out. You have to give it to Kana for this round specifically because of those two positions. Now, there's that foot sweep she tried.
Beautiful.
Kana raped
absolutely beautiful.
But there was nothing that happens with it. So how much do you count that? It looks great. It looks amazing, but you didn't really land anything once you got there. And, of course, here with Uchimata, she gets it down to the ground, and rightfully so. Shizuka, she tries to get out. She rolls over. You get thrown that way. Don't stop the momentum. Continue with it. Keep going. But she gave it her back. And, of course, we saw her get out of this position, even though after the throw was very good. But there is a position within the mixed martial arts where you're in the middle of a throw. You have to make up your mind. Keep defending myself against it, or I just go with it. She did the right decision to go with it and got herself caught in part of back mount.
Absolutely. In terms of judging that first round, though, a mutual friend of ours, and Big John McCarthy, told me, you're judging as well now. You're reffing now. John always told me, listen, man, when you're taking a look at a fight, who's trying to end the fight? Who's trying to put a stoppage in place here? And when you have a submission attempt there, people can say, oh, it wasn't close. It was close. It's still an attempt to end the fight, which in essence is the purpose of mixed martial arts. You're trying to end the fight.
And there's too many fighters that we have seen lately in the last couple of years that they like to wait the three rounds and the five rounds to win the decision. And it makes it a lot more difficult to judge those fights because they're not trying to finish the fight. They're just trying to win each and every round. Obviously, with that, we're looking at, and here we go again, we're looking at Kana. She's trying to find a way to finish this fight. For her, the best place to do it is on the ground, and that's what she's trying to push, and she's forcing this issue as much as possible. And so, yes, every time you look at it from a judging standpoint, she's the one trying to finish the fight. She obviously is the one that
she's
has to get the mat.
Controlling where
point.
The action is taking place.
Yes.
I mean, it's the oldest rule in the book. Stay away from a wrestler, stay away from judoka if you're a striker. You cannot allow them to get close to distance. You can't get their hips anywhere near your hips. But a great job here by Sugiyama, able to reverse the position. Now she's trying to go in there, but again, Watanabe way ahead of the game, rolling out there, protecting her back, not allowing the hooks to get in there, Frank.
And you look at her, she's rolling herself out. Like she's grabbing a leg, so she can't, she's not giving up her back. She's trying to roll under. She's actually grabbed her own arm in this position. She will try to sit up and she'll try to step over with her left leg, get all across the body and try to roll Shizuka down to her back to try to step on top of her. Obviously, she knows it's coming, so she's putting herself out of there, but she's doing a great job at this young point in her career. Remember, she's only 1-0, Kana, who's on the bottom right now. She's only 1-0. She's doing a great job of making sure she doesn't get in bad positions, even though she is in a pretty bad position, being in turtle position, on her hands and knees right now.
Well, you can see Sugiyama trying to pull the body across, because if you pull the body across, it'll open up the left hip. And if you get that left hip open, that you can then begin to put your hooks in. As you can see with Watanabe, she's trying to sneak out.
She's trying to find a way out the back door, trying to find a way to save herself. Obviously, in this position, she can't. If you look at the body position, she can't strike. Kana is stuck in a position where she has no strike. She has no ability to submit in this position either. But now she has a shot, because now she might be on top. She's a shot to kind of revolve. We got to see what happens. Are they going to pull off the ropes? Or they can let them keep going in this spot?
Well, Herzog did mention action, and then the girls did actually move. But now they find themselves, like you said, in the ropes here. So now we're back into the same position here.
And that's what she wanted to do. She wanted that leg the entire time to step over. And now she's in a position where she's trying to get back on top. But of course, Sujab with the wizard stopping that from happening.
Great job by the ladies here in this scramble here. It's all about hand positioning. It's all about hip positioning. And it all depends on where the momentum is going. And when you have a judoka, they just understand where the body moves. It's like a jiu-jitsu player. A jiu-jitsu player knows, an experienced jiu-jitsu player knows exactly what the body is going to be doing to set up a submission. Do this. It's like human chess. Well, another attempt there by Watanabe, and a good knee, but she falls back to Sugiyama.
And that comes from her always looking for foot sweeps, always looking to kick the calf. And as a result, she got knee in the stomach, kind of Watanabe. She got kicked in the calf, in the abs pretty hard, took that hard knee, but in the middle of it, she's throwing her leg out there. She's looking for a foot sweep and to put it down on the ground.
Doesn't take much. She just needs one limb. And someone's going down on the ground. Now, once again, she's trying to go for that rear naked choke, but it's too difficult. It's more of a headlock right now. Playing the foot sweep game. A nice knee attempt there by Sugiyama. Watanabe holding on to Sugiyama's right arm, trying to turn the balance over so that when she does step, she can then go for a Taiyatoshi. She can do something over to the side, but now it's Sugiyama. Boom, the kicks to the body, attempting the knees. Both ladies have their hands low, Frank.
Both are exhausted at this point. Both of them are getting super tired from all this. So they have nothing to look at now at this point of the fight. Where does experience actually take over, and where does young heart take over? We're going to start to see Sugiyama come in really with her hands a little bit higher, throw a lot more punches. You see her trying to feint, where Watanabe, she's spending most of her time trying to look for another takedown. So what's going to push the judges favor in this point of the fight?
30 seconds to go, second round. Watanabe taking on Sugiyama. Both ladies, you know, obviously fatigued. And we should make a note that although Frank and I were speaking about that first round, who would we give it to? Irrelevant, ladies and gentlemen. It's Japanese mixed martial arts. It's Ryzen. The fight will be judged. And a great right hand. Two right hands landed by Sugiyama. Closing the round strong. So just to finish off my point, Frank, You and I can sit here and judge round one. We can sit here and judge round two. Completely and utterly irrelevant. We have to judge the fight as a whole when it comes to an end. Should it go the distance?
Right now, if the fight were to end, I'd have a very difficult time trying to give it to Kana. I'd have to give it to Suzuka just because she's the one now laying the punches. She's doing a lot more damage. Yeah, the trips and the takedowns and the back control look great.
Nice teeth there. But no. Gets taken down.
See, and I'm sorry. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen at home. I said it was I thought it was a knee, and then she caught that leg and put it on her butt, and that is the result. So in that position, what did more damage? The teeth did more damage or the takedown do more damage?
I would go with the teeth.
And that's what I have to go with as well. So you're looking at now, what's the damaging factor? Who's trying to finish the fight? Well, at this point, you have to give it to Tsujiyama if you're judging the fight right now at the end of it.
So as we take a look at this, you know, both fighters, you got Sugiyama, who's, you know, just breathing somewhat heavy, but Watanabe has got her mouthpiece out, breathing heavily through the mouth, eyes are closed, getting as much oxygen as possible into her body, which is what you need to do when you're in the corner. Load your body up with oxygen, because guess what? You got 5 more minutes to go, potentially.
It's only 5 minutes, though. It's not that long.
No, no, of course not. Ladies, very respectful, touching of the gloves here. It seems that Watanabe, you know, she likes to strike, but the goal is to get inside.
100%.
Arm over the head.
And why would you?
Oh, beautiful.
See, because of things like that, why would you change your style? That's what got you in the show. Let's improve on, let's make you a better fighter by keeping you at your root, keeping you at your base. Her entire career should be spent trying to throw punches and grab a hold of you. Now she needs to change her stance, because every time she steps in, she's leaving her stomach open, and she's getting caught with knees, she's getting caught with punches as she steps in, because she steps in very heavy right-handed leg. And as a result, she's taking a lot of damage in that position. Well, not a lot, but she's taking damage, more damage than she's giving out of this point.
I mean, in my opinion, that's when Ronda Rousey was at her finest. Forget the boxing and the kickboxing, get inside and launch your opponent. I used to always be surprised when her opponents would actually try and engage with her and get too close to her. You can't do that with a judoka, especially a Ronda Rousey's caliber. She'll launch you.
And it happened more. We saw her throw, you know, her first 10 fights, she saw her throw me to the ground and finish. And, but you also have to say, you know, she opened up the eyes of a lot of judokas. It's time for me to make the switch. When my judo career is over, I actually have some place I can go to. I now can jump into mixed martial arts as a full-time career and make a little bit of money that I wasn't making at the amateur level.
And I mean, judo here in Japan is absolutely massive.
It's the best. I mean, it's the best in the world. It has been for a very long time. Obviously, it's the birthplace of judo, so as a result, they have a leg up on the rest of us. No matter how many times you try to catch them, it's still very difficult.
It's all about martial arts here in Japan. Heck, even the sumo wrestlers that we've seen. I mean,
yeah.
I'm not gonna lie to you. At 5'7", I'm a tad intimidated by them.
I just know that they can't chase me. I can run away.
Good point. You're obviously mount here for Watanabe. A little close to the rope. She's not trying to get separation. She's trying to control the head here. But if she can realize, if she can get that left arm free, Frank, her opponent's left arm off to the side, she can start raining down some punches. I'm wondering if she's trying to get that arm to come across the other way as her opponent tries to turn. Because if she lets her turn, Frank, she'll have her back.
Well, she's holding that arm so she can't get away. I thought she was trying to step an arm bar. Because obviously that's how she won her first fight. It looked like she's trying to go to that direction, but you're right, Joe. All she was trying to do is keep her flat on her back. And she would have been better served, and this is from experience. Obviously, she's very, very new at the fight game. That if you had the experience with, they want to give me their back, I'll take their back. They have a better shot of finishing in this position. You do an armbar. I mean, statistically speaking.
Her hips are so low, though. She's got, see, this is what I was saying before, but where her hips are now, she's not going to, there's no way that armbar can happen. You're going to have to sort of crawl up there. So, in terms of what she's doing here, she's pressing down, keeping her opponent flat. She should actually crawl up. Greg Jackson told me this many times. Keep your knees tight, crawl up there, get your base proper, and just start raining down the punches.
Sit up and separate. How much damage is happening right here? What is actually going to finish the fight from this position? There's nothing here.
Your opponent's trying to buck. Go with it. Kenny Florian's told me this.
Yes.
Let them buck. And as they buck, you turn with them.
Yeah, let it go. There's very few submissions she can pull from this position. Obviously, from an amateur judo standpoint, she's already got the pin. She's had her down there for 30 seconds. She's able to hold her there. So from a judo standpoint, this fight is over, which is her backyard. This is what she does. Unfortunately, she needs to spend more time doing this. sitting up and raining down. There's the armbar.
This is a very dangerous position right now for Sugiyama. She's got to get a higher. Oh, look, here we go. She's trying to turn out. The wrist is over. The arm is a bit twisted over. It's not hyperextending the elbow.
She turned her thumb. She's able to get herself out of it. She's in a good position.
Welcome to Japan. MMA kicks to the head. Soccer kicks. Stomps to the skull. You want to put me in an armbar? You're going to taste my foot, Frank.
And this is in this position, it's not going to do a lot of damage, these foot stomps, these soccer kicks. But they're going to do enough to force her to have to let go of the arm if she can run off two or three in a row. She's going to have to let go of this arm. No matter what happens, if Kana has a hold of
she's
you,
got 40 se-
she's
under
got
40
a shot
seconds.
To finish.
Yes. If anything, I mean, should Sugiyama be doing this or just stacking her opponent and slowly pulling out her elbow?
It's a difficult situation because there's also a lot of feel that's going on inside of here. Does it feel tight? Do I feel like I'm in trouble? Does it feel like I'm in danger? If it's not that kind of a situation, then I'll just keep going ahead and kick me in the head. But if I do feel like I'm in trouble, I have to defend the problem first. What is the problem? Well, the problem is I'm caught in an armbar. Let's defend that arm first.
The issue with the arm, though, is it's not going to hyperextend. The elbow is past the area, the fulcrum, that would be required to push it off. There you have it. So now you judge this fight and think to yourself, well, wait a second. Who did more? Who did what?
I say Sugiyama did more. I was saying that last sequence, yeah, she was cutting an armbar, but once it was out, it was out. She kept stomping on her head. That's more damage. That stuff's going to finish her fight. Now, you are looking at a position where once she forced her to the ground, she was able to do some punching, have to force her to move. But this is the problem with this round. She laid on her like this entire time. If she had sat up earlier, she probably would have had a better shot of finishing her because she would have had more time in case she missed the armbar. Because there was such a little amount of time left when she rolled into this armbar, she had no choice but to keep sticking with it, hoping to get the finish before the final bell. She did it 2 minutes before.
Yes.
She could have let this go, sat up, and went back to it again later.
Well, as soon as she began striking, we're thinking, why is she holding on to the position for so long? As soon as she began to strike, it was strictly there for her opponent to react so she can go for the armbar. I think she could have did it much, much sooner.
Judge Oyabu Watanabe. Judge Tazawa Watanabe.
Whoa.
Judge Takamoto Watanabe. Yotte Shousha Watanabe.
In just her second professional mixed martial arts fight, Kana Watanabe takes out an opponent with a record of 15-4-1, making her go to 15-5-1. I personally agree with the judge's decision, Frank, because I believe overall she did more to try and end this fight than her opponent. Great performance there by Watanabe. Like I said, just in her second fight here. Love to hear what she has to say. She got a package in the mail, apparently, Frank.
There are a multitude of sponsors. They have to run here, guys, and make the show run well. The winners get to carry a lot of packages out.
And trophies.
And trophies. You are correct. I apologize. And trophies.
Ah, there's the microphone. All right, let's hear what she has to say.
こんばんは、ファイターズフロー所属の渡辺香奈です、今日はこんな大きな舞台に立たせていただいて
大臣さん、坂木原会長
どうもありがとうございました
She is thanking Sakakibara.
こんなたくさんの応援も本当にありがとうございます
cheers, Frank.、
私はまだ2戦目なんですけどどうですか
Explaining that this was just only my second fight. I am sorry. She's apologizing to the crowd for being unable to finish the fight. And she asked the crowd, did I prove myself against a veteran? And obviously, they applauded.
そしてディープジュエルス 全部どんどん自分が引っ張って盛り上げていきたいです。いい選手もたくさんいます。これからも応援よろしくお願いします。あと
Bold statement, Frank. I'm here to stay and I will be the new face of women's mixed martial arts in Japan.
もっと反省すべきところがいっぱいあるんですけど、
There are many good girls here in Japan.
もっと強い人とやらせてください。もっともっと強くなります。よろしくお願いします。ありがとうございました。
She says, yes, I will continue to fight, I will continue to win, but you need to give me tougher opponents. And thanks the crowd. Like I said, when she first came out, she has the opportunity to be an absolutely huge star here in Japan. But what you said is absolutely correct. It takes time. She's now 2-0.Obviously, with any errors that she made in this fight here, she will correct them. Obviously, you know, you and I were talking about the fact that mouth could have been changed much earlier and got that submission attempt earlier.
And it's this experience level, and it's coaching, and there's a lot of factors involved. It's also, too, how much does she want to improve? She made a